Let's see how this works. Recall that the instantaneous value of the voltage for a sinusoidal waveform can be calculated using the formula E instantaneous, or EI, equals E peak times the sine of theta. Here's a picture of a sinusoidal waveform that can be described with this equation. The peak amplitude of this waveform is 10 volts. So at 0 degrees, there is 0 volts. At 45 degrees, the voltage has risen to 10 times the sine of 45 degrees, or 7.07 volts. At 90 degrees, the voltage has risen to 10 volts. At 135 degrees, the voltage has declined to 7.07 volts. The voltage continues to decline during this portion of the waveform. During the negative alternation, the voltage amplitude varies in the same manner, but with opposite, that is, negative polarity. Now, for each of these instantaneous voltage values, we can use Ohm's law to calculate the current value, just as if each instantaneous voltage were produced by a battery, EI, placed in the circuit at the right moment. At 0 degrees, the instantaneous value of the voltage is zero. So according to Ohm's law, the current equals the voltage over the resistance, or 0 amperes. At 45 degrees, the instantaneous voltage is 7.07 volts. This can be represented by a 7.07 volt battery, as shown in this circuit. Using Ohm's law, we have 7.07 volts divided by 1,000 ohms, or 7.07 milliamps, of current flow. Instantaneous current values continue to vary this way throughout the entire cycle. In the negative alternation, however, we plot the curve as negative because its direction of flow is opposite to the direction we call positive. Now, if all these points are connected with a smooth curve, it's found that the current, like the voltage, is also sinusoidal.